So please rejoin with us. We have a mango tree. If you are hungry, then you can take mango also. So dear devotees, please try to look at the board. And first you listen to me. What is this? Why it is written? See, first thing is that all of you or all of us, in some way we are a leader. Someone is looking at us. Someone is following us. It may apply to a father, a teacher, a counselor, a mentor, a guide, a society leader, a temple president, a manager, or anyone. Those who are in some leadership position. So here we are talking in context of Vidura is teaching to or counseling to Dhritarashtra. Okay, counseling to Dhritarashtra. So you have also some people with you, under you, and you teach them, you counsel them. So here the point is that to whom we can counsel, to whom we can teach, and all of us we want that they should follow us, everyone, that my counselee, my student, my wife, my children, whoever the subordinate, they should follow us. We want that. And we give time and energy to them. We want they should follow us and they should behave in a proper way and so on. So if you are a Baba staying in Radhakund or somewhere, then you are happy with your bhajan. No one bother you. You also don't bother to anyone. But if you are staying in a setup, you are staying in an institute where the fellow devotees are there, and the batchmates are there, and the seniors are there. We are staying in a group of devotees, and we are also preaching. We want them to follow. So in such situation, Vidura counseled Dhritarashtra. And the result, you know that whatever we'll discuss that, Dhritarashtra, whether he listened or not. But in general, I'm saying, oftentimes we teach, hey, ye karo, wo karo, do this, do that. With this, we tend to teach. And especially to our own counselees, our followers, we expect that they should follow us. So this is a very nice principle, my dear devotees. It may be outside, but if we see this, if we apply this, I heard from my senior, it helps a lot. I can tell you, frankly, I'm applying, it helps a lot. When we can teach others, that we have to know. Anyone who is under us, any subordinates. First and foremost thing is that first quality you have to is modeling. First quality is modeling. Modeling means what? We have to be very exemplary. We ourselves have to be very exemplary and trustworthy. Show ourselves. First, that's called modeling. In every aspect, in our sadhana, in our dealings, in our sadachar, in every aspect, first point, before reaching to the last one, teaching, we prone to teach. we tend to teach. We generally say, you do this, you do that, you do this, you do that. We say then. So please, my dear devotees, before reaching the fourth stage, teaching, first we have to take care of modeling ourselves. Is that it's we ourselves in our personal life, codes and conducts, everything, we have to be very exemplary. To whom we counsel, to whom we teach, to whom we guide, mentor, they see us. They look at us. They see us. So therefore, this is the root of the tree. If you want to develop a strong relationship, therefore, the title is relationship building in any field. I say to you, frankly, in family life, starting from family life, to corporates, to education, to social or spiritual organization, any life, anytime, anywhere. So root is modeling. First, we have to be all exemplary in our codes and conducts, in our dealings, in our behavior. They look at us. They see us. Once you are modeled, you are perfect in your dealings and your practice. Then the second comes mentoring. The second one comes mentoring. Mentoring means what? Actually, for every point, there is a verse from Shastra, Bhagavad Gita. I will tell you later. But first, you understand the principle. Mentoring means care and inspiration. Again, a husband to his wife, a father to his son, a counselor to his counselor, a teacher to his students, a president to his subordinates, a HOD to his subordinates. Anyone. First, second one is mentoring. That you have to care for them. Care, everything comes in the care. Physical need, spiritual need, emotional need, ethical need. All types of care come in that. You just can't be indifferent. You remain in this, in your own world. That's why I said, this is not for them, those who are try to do bhajan in oneself, staying in one kutir. But if you are in an organization, if you are in a setup, where you become a model or example for some or other. So second one is mentoring. Mentoring means from a distance, you we care for him. Make a plate for him, prasadam plate. Or do something. It's not that only the juniors can make a plate for seniors. If it is required, what does he require? What does he needs? For example, I am saying, in that sense, you can take so many things. What is care and inspiration? Inspire that person. Inspire fasting. Oh, you can make it. You definitely can make it. You can sing. You can be a singer. Like sometimes I say to Asadaspu, that you learn harmonium. You learn from others how Sambal Rampu is wonderfully playing harmonium. Inspire him. Try to know the quality which is there within him. And fan it. Inspire him. So inspiration is such a boost, no? Even a layman can... means Pangu Langhayate Giri. Yes. So that is mentoring. When you do these two things, first you model yourself and then mentor, means in care and inspiration, then that person, that subordinate, he or she develop trust on you. That Prabhuji, Mataji is always with me at any time. So he or she develop trust. And then third one comes. See, caring inspiration is one thing, but the most another important thing is organization. What is meant by organization? It's culture. whatever is favorable for his Krishna consciousness, you provide him. Whatever. It may be some simple article, something, simple headset or something. From there till intervening in his family life, for example, protecting him, guiding him, counseling his parents, counseling his friends and relatives, to that extent, if it is required, whenever you give support in all, through all various ways. For that, this is action. See, this may be in a subtle platform, means like verbal, but organization is, this is action plan. You have to do some tangible, practical, so that it will help that person enhance in his or her Krishna consciousness. For that, whatever is required. And then comes teaching. Fourth one is teaching. And then you can teach him. At that stage, when Arjuna was surrendered and Krishna started teaching in second chapter. So at that stage, when you say something to that subordinate, he will definitely follow you. Because you have completed other three. First, you became your exemplary. Second, you took care and inspired him. And then you did action plan to help him or her in his Krishna consciousness, whatever is possible way. And then he said, Prabhu, 11 o'clock, my class is there. That's all, enough for that person. He knows what to do. Then comes teaching. Oftenly, what we mistakenly we do, first this thing. Hey, do this. Hey, do that. This is not good. This is good. This is... We tend to always correct others, teach others in this way. But have you invested these things before? If you have invested, then you have the right to teach that person. And they will also surrender you and they will follow you. So this is called MMOT. So, MMOT. So, in any setup, you can apply this and try to develop our relationship with others, with subordinates, with our batchmates, with our equals, peers, whatever you can say. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.